ALS, alternative learning systems.
Between India and Pakistan, India has always objected to third-party mediation. What could be the reason for India strongly opposing any sort of third-party mediation? In fact, recently, when Prime Minister Imran Khan visited US, after his bilateral summit-level talks with President Trump, in fact, President Trump indicated that he is willing to mediate if both, initially he said even Prime Minister Modi has requested him, but later on he changed his tact and said that, no, if both the sides want, I will mediate. This position was taken by US a couple of times earlier also. But India has very, categorically and unequivocally declared that we don't want any third party mediation when it comes to our relationship with Pakistan and the problems with Pakistan. First of all, let us not forget that in the Kashmir issue, in 1948 itself, we have taken, once Pakistan supported troops started attacking Kashmir, and once the instrument of accession was signed between India and Kashmir, or Kashmir signed the instrument of accession, India sent our troops. When the war was going on, we approached the UN for mediation, and a ceasefire was declared, and that is the ceasefire line of 1948 today. We know what were the ill effects of that. Even today, the UN could not mediate and resolve because of the Cold War politics and things like that. So, the first big setback for India was our approach to UN and the UN's inability to solve the problem. UN has not solved even today. So, we have burned our fingers for the first time in 1948 itself. Subsequently, during Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru's time, we took initiative for starting the non-aligned movement, NAM. And non-aligned movement's idea was to keep away from the bloc politics. And strategic independence was a key theme. And we realized during this time that the bloc politics can always be harmful. And if you allow somebody to come and mediate, especially these powerful countries, it will always be harmful to us. We may not be able to get the real justice, because these powerful countries also will try to extract their own benefits out of the whole problem. They will fish in the troubled water. So, right from the non-aligned movement principle, we have decided that these bloc politics and these powerful countries should be kept away from our day-to-day problems. Number three, in the 1965 war, or when the war was at its peak, when we were about to be defeat Pakistan in 1965, the USSR interfered and mediated and forced a ceasefire on us, or we agreed for a ceasefire. Then came the Tashkent Agreement in 1966. January 10th, we had the Tashkent Agreement. And Lal Bahadur Shastri, our then Prime Minister, he had a very tough time because of the pressure from the Soviet Union. And under pressure, we agreed to withdraw behind the LOC or line of control before the war situation, or rather whatever we were holding before the war, we agreed to withdraw back to that position. And we had to give up some of the strategic locations we captured in the 1965 war because of the pressure from the USSR. We realized that any third party mediation of this nature can be of harm to us. That is what we learned even in the 1965 war. Then came the 1971 war, the Bangladesh war, we defeated Pakistan. Then finally in 1972, the Shimla Agreement came. In the Shimla Agreement, we ensured that there is no third party mediation. We also wrote very categorically, unequivocally, that between India and Pakistan, we will resolve our problems bilaterally and no third party mediation. Because of our experience in the past, our experience of 1965 war and the Tashkent Agreement, our experience of taking this problem to UN and subsequently no solution from the UN. So, we were very clear by 1972 Shimla Agreement that there should not be any third party mediation. We even declared that line of control should be respected at any cost. That will be, that is the de facto boundary for India, between India and Pakistan, and the line of control to be respected at any cost and no third party mediation. That is what we insisted in the 1972 Shimla Agreement. Then any third party mediation, please remember, only powerful countries will come and mediate for you. Smaller countries like Nepal and Bhutan cannot mediate for us. So if a powerful country come, they will be more powerful than us, and they will put their pressure, their own vested interest also will be taken care in the process, and we will be the loser. That is what we learned. And that is why even in the Lahore Declaration of 1999, when Prime Minister Vajpayee visited Lahore, we reiterated our Shimla agreement, and we also once again very categorically declared that no third party mediation between India and Pakistan. We will resolve our problems bilaterally. That is the stand we are taking even today. And one more point I would like to say here is, with the unilateral withdrawal of withdrawal of Article 370 by India recently, naturally then the focus will be once again on Kashmir. There will be pressure, many people, and Pakistan has already retaliated by expelling Indian envoy from Islamabad and things like that. Things are getting into a murkier and bitter situation. Any third party mediation, even many countries may even offer also. So at this time, once again, India should realize that anybody coming will be coming with their own motive and interest, which can be affecting our own sovereign interest ultimately. So in the genuine interest of India and India's future, we should try to resolve these problems bilaterally. But that resolution requires both the sides to participate. So we are taking a very stern stand on certain things. We have further complicated the matter suddenly by declaring that Article 370 is withdrawn or scrapped and things like that. So we are also taking steps which are not conducive for have a peaceful dialogue and discussion between India and Pakistan. So we should be focusing on how to bring our these issues back to the table, to a negotiation table, without any external interference. We should be able to deal with Pakistan, dialogue. We should, at some point of time, we will have to start dialogue with Pakistan. We can always claim that we have nothing to talk to you because Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India. That can be a posturing. But the reality is, Jammu and Kashmir is a bone of contention between India and Pakistan. Jammu and Kashmir might have joined Indian Union through a legal, a proper legal manner, that instrument of accession, which is ratified by the British Parliament also. But that does not mean that the problem is not there. So we should have the courage and guts to talk to Pakistan. We should be talking from our strength. Our strength is, it is our territory, and we should somehow bring Kashmiri people also onto the, bring them into confidence. We cannot take unilateral steps the way we are taking and destroy the confidence. The nationalist politicians in Jammu and Kashmir has been completely relegated to the back seat. We are even ignoring them right now. We need them. We need the people of Kashmir. Kashmir alone is not sufficient. Kashmiri people also should be with us. So, we can capture a territory, we can hold on to a territory, but we have to win over the hearts of the people also. We need discussion and dialogue. So, if we can have dialogue and discussion with the people of Kashmir, and ultimately if we can have discussion and dialogue with Pakistan, we will be able to avoid the interference of the third parties. And ultimately, please remember, any third party mediation can be harmful for India. There is absolutely no doubt for India and not for us. So, the final position is, India has been very clear since Shimla agreement that no third party mediation, and we are continuing to hold on to this position since then.